So I was thinking as you were just about to come in here that this has been an incredible journey. And, you know, it seems to have sort of flown by. It feels like to me. What how does it feel to you now to be sitting here at the very last junket of the last movie that from this idea that you had to now? Is it sort of mind-blowing? Is it sort of like now you're so used to it because every year it kind of happens, every year there's another one? Or are you still sort of shocked by...
I'm still shocked. It seems like a really long time. It doesn't seem like it's flown by at all. It's when they say, you know, it's only been 5 years since we started doing Twilight, it's like, really? Because it feels like a solid decade. And then another decade back to when I started writing, which was not quite 10 years ago. But everything's made, things have changed so much. My kids have grown up. Yeah, I've moved. It just doesn't feel like the same life in a lot of ways. But it's still kind of shocking when you get to this part. It's like, oh yeah, I have to be in front of cameras and stuff. You know, it's weird.
Do you, obviously you wrote the book and you create these characters, but because you've been such an integral part of the movies and we've watched these group of key, you know, key group of 3 or 10 or, you know, the group keeps getting bigger, really grow up before our eyes and sort of change and become the people who they are. Has that been an exciting, interesting process that you are at all prepared for, or?
It makes you feel old. I mean, when you, with this episode of the movie, when we look back and we see Kristen at 17, and you forget, you know, that she didn't always look like this. Oh, she was a baby when we started. She's grown up so much, and it does make me feel really old. It's nice, though. I mean, it's nice that we've gotten to spend such a long time with the same group of people, because you get to have a relationship. It's not just a new set of faces every time. I miss all of them. It's been a long time since we got to hang out together, so today's been kind of fun.
Do you notice, I mean, I was thinking too, the other thing I was thinking about was that I had this idea, you know, this week that in 10 years, in 25 years, like, you go off and make something, and for most people, I think you make a movie, it's great, you might be friends, your paths may cross, but I was thinking, like, the way I feel about, I don't know, Sound of Music, when they bring out the 25th anniversary, the 50th anniversary, that this thing is gonna live on for a lot longer than, you know, forever, and that there will be these almost reunions. It's almost like its own little high school reunion coming together at these sort of key benchmarks of time and sort of following everyone's lives, I guess.
That would be really cool. You know, I was just looking at a magazine that was doing reunions from different shows, and I didn't even think about this, but how cool will it be to see people in 25 years? Oh man, that's a long time. I have been looking forward to see, you know, what the kids are going to do next and what their next projects are, and that's really been fun. I'm excited for them now that they're kind of free. They get to go do, you know, whatever. It'll be so interesting to see how they turn out, because they are still kids. A lot of growing up.
What's been, I think, you know, you go, and it's interesting because sort of like, I guess like the Bond movies where every movie's a different director. I mean, do you feel like you had such a different experience with each one of these movies that you can sort of cherish for its own, the good, the bad, whatever it was, but you have 5 experiences that are related, but you know, vastly different.
I felt like I learned so much from having different directors. Initially, I was very resistant to the idea because I was like, no, you know, Catherine did a great job. Everybody loves what the product was. Let's stay with her. And then as soon as we started working with Chris, it was like, oh, this is a whole different way of doing things. And then with David, again, a completely different style. And so I feel like just for my personal experience, it's been really great because I've learned so much. You know, and you just wouldn't know what different options and angles you could have had without that. So I think it's been a really positive experience.
And because you sort of worked, because you did work with Melissa and all of them, did it get to sort of this rhythm where you felt like you were sort of protecting what you created and yet at the same time you have to let so much go?
Yeah, I mean, Melissa and I have worked together pretty well from the beginning. She's always extremely collaborative. She's not precious about her work. I'm like, no, this is how it must be. She listens really well, and she gets excited about different angles. And with this last one, I think we both got excited about some of the things that we were going to venture slightly off the page with and how we were going to do that. We became a whole new little creative angle. And so working with her has always been a lot of fun. It's nice to have, as much fun as it was to have different directors and learn some things, the continuity's been great to have Melissa, to have the actors, you know, be the familiar faces. And that's the group we've moved, we've graduated with.
when it was coming to this one, and there were so many new vampires to introduce, was that exciting to just think of, like, you conceive all these people in your mind, and then all of a sudden it's not just like getting used to Rob, Taylor, and Kristen as Bella, Edward, and Jacob, but to get, is Rami Malek how you pictured Benjamin? And is, I mean, was that fun to be involved and see all those people come to life? And
that was such a blast. Casting all the new vampires. I mean, there were two different aspects of it. There was the casting, which I love casting. And we had so many really great people try out. And some of it was kind of heartbreaking because you're like, I mean, obviously Lee Pace is going to be Garrett. No questions asked. But there were some really great other directions. It's like, I hate saying no to that person. I would love to work with that person. And and so that was rough, but it was so much fun to have so many different looks. And then the actual having them on set was great because we've been doing this for a really long time. And, you know, there is a grind to it. It's a long day's work every day, and you get a little burned out. And then you have 40 super happy new vampires who are just jazzed to be there every day. And that really does, like, lift the whole feel of it. And I think they were responsible for what was the most fun moment I think we've ever had on filming a Twilight movie. There was a lot of lightheartedness with this group, and it was great having them.
Was that moment you're referring to, the
dance off? Yeah. Man, and I get it, because I'm a work person. When there's work to be done, I do it. I don't mess around. We don't waste time, and so I get that side of it. But was it fun to have that shift for just a minute? And hey, we're just gonna laugh for 20 minutes here. It was great.
What would you say has been sort of your biggest surprise about the whole process of where we got to today?
I mean, there's sort of the constant surprise of you read something in the script and you're like, this doesn't feel right. I don't know. And then the director talks to you and you let's see it. And then you realize you weren't hearing it in the right intonation. You weren't seeing it right. It's like, okay, this totally works. There was a scene like that in Twilight, just when the girls were at the table. And Bella said something that seemed totally out of character to me for her. And I kind of pushed back with Melissa. And she's like, no, it'll be great. And it was. And then back then, I wasn't as involved. It's like, okay. And then when Kristen did the line, I'm like, oh, I totally get it now. She was jumping in to save this other girl. And I hadn't read it that way. And so it was just me being short-sighted. And so there's always those moments where this isn't working right. And then you see the actress, and it's like, okay, yeah, they have it under control. I think another big surprise was when Kristen became Vampire Kristen. Because I was worried, is it going to be too different? Is it going to not be different enough? Is she going to seem like she is something more? And she totally nailed it. And so that was a happy surprise. I was hoping for it. I thought she was going to get there, but it was always like, I had no idea what it was going to look like. And then when she did, it was like, yes, yay.
What I don't expect that you set out, to thought, and I don't know if you did this consciously, to sort of make something that literally was a strong female character at the center of something, because what's been created is the first time we've seen really a franchise, which some people think it's a bad word or a good word depending on where you are, built around a strong, interesting female character who has her flaws and her weaknesses, but she is genuinely who she is and is, like, for a teenager in high school, like, pretty sure who she is. Mm-hmm. And create someone that I think is a role model to girls everywhere.
Well, I wouldn't say role model, but I do hope that they can find things to identify in with her and things that they can learn from. Like, she definitely knows what she wants, and in the end, she gets what she wants. I think there's a strength in her that reminds me a little bit of, one of my favorite heroines is Jane Eyre, because she's a very quiet heroine. She doesn't wield a sword, she's not taking on ninjas, but she knows who she is and she never budges. Like, she just is who she is. And I love that. And there's a strength to that. Now, Bella gets to get really strong by the end, which is great too. But it's something that I've thought about a lot over the last couple of years. It makes me a little bit sad that we don't have a greater range of female heroines to look at. It makes me sad that when a woman writes a book from a woman's perspective, pretty much only women read it, whereas I read books written by men about men's perspective all the time. And this could be why men don't think they understand women, because you don't read our perspective as much as we read yours. And I think that's sad. I'm hoping that that's something that changes as there are more books out there. And obviously this has a very romantic leaning, which is going to appeal more to girls, but you know, like Hunger Games is great where you have something that is from a girl's perspective, written by a woman, and men are reading it. And that makes me just want to cheer because good, you know, let's stop worrying about whose perspective we're reading from. Let's learn something about each other.
And my last question, is there a favorite moment? Is there some moment that you went, Kristen trying on the wedding dress, some moment where you were there and you thought, wow, I never thought this would be it in this, you know, and you kept that moment.
You know, there were a lot of them on this last movie because there were so many big moments in the characters' lives. When Edward delivers the baby and Rob, you know, here we're thinking, here's this slippery baby covered in goop. He's gonna drop the baby, you know, and he has those big, huge hands and he's just cradling it and the baby stops crying once again and it was beautiful. And like, he was so tender with the children all through the different stages. You know, Kristen obviously walking down the aisle because she brought, like, she did it for real. She was so in that moment. It wasn't acting, she was just there. And it was, you know, it was like being at the coolest wedding you'd ever been invited to, where you really loved the people that were getting married and you were happy for them. You know, and then being on a beach for the last night of shooting and spending, you know, when the camera wasn't running, you're walking through this perfectly warm surf at midnight and it's over, but you're in such a beautiful, peaceful place. That was also a really great moment.
Nice bookend to the other moment at the beginning of filming, Stranded.
Where we were stranded on a deserted island with 140 people and like 3 cups of water and 8 beds and no food. Yeah, that was a very dramatic way to start things off, but we all survived. So it was probably a bonding experience. That was a funny night though, because you know, I remember when it got really bad and Kristen and Rob were close enough by that they'd been able to evacuate. And they came back and said, Stephanie, you know, let's get you out of here. And yeah, I looked around everybody, I'm like, I can't do that. That's such a lame move. I'm not gonna go. And then they tried to get Bill to go and he's like, I'm not leaving the ship. And we just stuck it out and then we felt really tough, I think, the next day. But we did make out alive. That was the important part.
Thank you.
Thank you, Eric Generic. That wasn't too generic at all.